Happy day, students. In our last class, we saw electric field along the axis of a uniformly charged ring, right? We have to discuss further about this. There is a ring here on which the total charge is Q, its radius is R, okay, and this is the axis, right? What we have found in this one, we found out that at the center of this ring, field is zero. We discussed it already, right? And what will be the field at infinity? The formula, first of all, I am writing E we found as Qx by 4 pi epsilon naught R square plus x square to the power 3 by 2, right? Is the formula. So if I am going to keep x equal to 0, what is x? This is x. X equal to 0 when you are keeping, E will become 0. No doubt about that, right? But if x I am going to keep infinity, then what is the value of the electric field? Then also it is 0. Why? Because we know that if we go at infinite distance from the charge, electric field become 0. Okay, theoretically we have studied that. But if suppose that you are banking on this formula, and from this formula you want to know if x is infinity, then what is electric field? That also I'll show you. What we can do, from this denominator, I'm taking x outside. Okay, see now. This Qx by 4 pi epsilon naught. Now I'm taking x outside, or you say x common. So x is what? X square. And here is what? Power 3 by 2. So x square to the power 3 by 2. What's going to come? X cube. X cube will come out. So x cube is here. Remaining R square by x square plus 1. Able to understand? If you suppose you want to see that whether the same thing is going to come or not, you just multiply it inside. Take this x cube inside. Okay? The things will come. When x cube will go inside, it will become x square. X square gets cancelled, and here x square will come. The same thing will come, right? So we arrange it like this. This x and this x cube gets cancelled. So what you are having now? Q by 4 pi epsilon naught x square by r square plus x square plus 1 to the power 3 by 2. Now put x equal to infinity. See what's coming. X equal to infinity, when you are going to keep here, r square by infinity square, that means this will become 0. 0 plus 1 to the power 3 by 2, that means 1. But here when you keep infinity, that entire thing becomes 0. That means electric field is 0 at infinity. Right? Which infinity? On this side or on this side? Both sides. Okay? Because the field of this ring will be along this direction also and along this direction also. Along this direction at infinity 0, in this direction also at infinity 0. Center also 0. But in the middle, there is a field. Am I correct? Because that's what we have found. So now, it means the field will be there in the middle, and then at infinity it will become 0. Right? Okay. So now we will try to find out where exactly the field is maximum. Okay? Where exactly the field is becoming maximum. That we will find now. Okay, so how to find? Now you see E is dependent on X. Electric field here is dependent on X. So if we want to find the maximum value, we know that we have to apply maxima function. So that means dE by dx. In differentiation, dE by dx we have to equate with 0. And we have to find X value, right? So, now this one here, what are the variable terms? Only x is variable. So, remaining all the things we will be taking outside here. So, q by 4 pi epsilon naught. We are not doing anything with that. Now, this is x. This is r square plus x square to the power 3 by 2. Take this as function u. Take this as function v. And start differentiating. So, what is the formula for u by v? V, differentiation of u plus... Sorry. U by V, right? Yeah. So V, I'll write it first. U by V. So V, differentiation of U minus U, differentiation of V by V square. Am I correct? This is the formula. So what is V here? V is R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2. What is U? X. So V here first, that is R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2. Then differentiation of U, which is X. So its differentiation with respect to X means 1. Minus. Then U, that means X. Then differentiation of V. The differentiation of V means R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2 is differentiation. So what will come? 3 by 2. R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2 minus 1. 3 by 2 minus 1 means half. Then differentiation of R square plus X square. R square is constant, so 0. Differentiation of X square means 2X. By R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2 square. V square. Now we have equated with what? 0. We equated with 0. But before that, let's solve it a bit. This 2 is getting cancelled over here, right? Now, we are going to equate this with 0. See what's coming. So, equal to 0. What will happen? The denominator term we are going to multiply over here. So, this is gone. So, that means this and this is equal to 0, right? This is in multiplication. Right, this is gone. Now this and this equal to 0. So what it is? R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2 minus, this is 3X. R square plus X square to the power half equal to 0. Take this one that side. So, and this is what? This is R square plus X square into R square plus X square to the power half, right? Equal to 3X, R square plus X square to the power half. This gets cancelled. Okay, now what we have? Here you see 3X into X is also there. So 3X square is here. So here, 3X square. Okay, so R square plus X square equal to 3X square. R square equal to 2x square. Okay, so x is equal to what? Plus minus r by root. Okay, this is the position at which we are going to get maximum electric field. So it's on one side or both sides? Both sides. Let me somewhere here. And say this is r by root 2 on the left. And here somewhere we can say r by root 2 on the right. Here the field is maximum. Here field is 0, here field is 0. So how to make the graph if we have to? It will be like this. Okay? We are saying the field is in this direction. But its maximum magnitude is here. Same way here also. But in this side, which direction will be the field? Field is always away from the positive charge. Right? So, along positive x-axis, we said that it is away from this, like this in that side. So, on this side, where will be the field? Like this. Okay? It's always away. Or you can keep plus 1 charge over here. See what's happening. Plus 1, this is going to repel it in this direction. So, field is in this direction. Okay? Now, the case is, in this case, if I have taken along positive x-axis, suppose I am taking the direction of field as positive. Right? So, in this direction, I have to take the field in negative direction. Yes or no? Correct or not? So, here, it will be making it like this. Okay? So, you can say R by root 2 somewhere here. So, this is how the direction or the graph of electric field variation along with x is made. Did you understand that? Okay. Further, we'll see what kind of questions we can frame on this one. And one more thing, if suppose that this ring would have negative charge, then what we would have done? Suppose the same ring is here, this is having negative charge. Then what would have been the field value? The formula would have been same. There's no change. Qx by 4 pi epsilon naught r square plus x square to the power 3 by 2. No change. But the direction of field would have been like this. That means always towards negative charge. And maximum also would have been at r by root 2. No change in that either. Okay. But here this is positive. So I would have made it like this. And here, that is only the difference. Not much of the differences. Right? This is negative x-axis, so I made it below to show that it's negative. Whereas this is towards positive direction, so I have made it above. That only is the difference between the charge positive and negative on the ring. Okay? Fine. So let us see some of the problems based on that. Now suppose that I have a ring which is having a positive charge. There is a positive charge over it. Okay, and here a negative charge is kept at the center. So radius we can say is r. Okay, at the center we have a negative charge. What is the force at that point? We know that field at the center is zero. So force also at the center will be zero only. So if force is zero, it's an equilibrium. Am I correct? Which equilibrium? Stable or unstable? How to find? We have to displace it from here. There's a negative charge. Suppose I'm going to displace it like this by x. Then, and I'm going to release it. What will happen? Is this positive going to attract this negative charge? If I'm going to keep negative over here, what will happen? This positive is going to attract it. Yes or no? When it's attracted, it will come back to the same position. That means this position is stable equilibrium position. If it is so, then the question comes, what is the time period of simple harmonic motion performed by minus Q charge? Okay, when it's displaced, when it's displaced by very small amount x, okay, displaced slightly, you can say, displaced slightly from mean position or equilibrium position. So when you are going to displace it from here, what is going to be the time period? That is the question. Let's find it. How to find it? We know that we have to find restoration force, which will bring it back to the mean position, right? So let's find it. We know already at this position, what is the electric field value? I'm not calculating it again, okay? We know it's electric field at x distance. Which direction is the electric field? Like this. Correct? So which direction will be the force on this one? In this direction. Because negative charge always move opposite to electric field. Remember that. Negative charge always move opposite to electric field, and positive charge always move along the electric field. Okay? So here, negative charge is here. So force on negative charge will be opposite to electric field. That means like this. So this force I am writing directly. Okay? What will be that force? I know that it will be QE. Right? So restoration force, so negative, I am giving it directly. So minus Q E value QX by 4 pi epsilon naught R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2. Right? This is the value of the electric field I have written. Now you can see that force is directly proportional to negative of X. So we know that it is doing SHM. It's the condition, right? So if this charge is also having mass M, put over here, MA equal to minus Q, QX by 4 pi epsilon naught R square plus X square to the power 3 by 2. Then this acceleration We know that in SHM, acceleration should be minus omega square x. That's equal to minus q qx by 4 pi epsilon naught r square plus x square to the power 3 by 2. This x and this x gets cancelled. Negative is gone. Right. We got omega value. And what is that omega value or omega square value? Let's check. Qq by 4 pi epsilon naught m. Now, r square plus x square. Now, x is large or small? Very small. R is very large as compared to x. So, we can neglect this x from here. So, what we can write? R square to the power 3 by 2. That means we can write r cube. So, omega will come root over qq by 4 pi epsilon naught m r cube. Okay, this way we can find what is going to be the frequency or time period of simple harmonic motion. Right? So, omega we got means time period also we got. Correct or not? Because time period is 2 pi by omega. Okay, let's solve one more question. Let's see how it is. So, suppose then we are going to make this ring in different way. Suppose that ring is like this now. Okay, I made it like this. And this is going to be the axis. This is having positive Q charge. Radius is R. And another positive charge I have. And its mass is M. And it is told to us that it's kept in equilibrium. Okay. It's kept in equilibrium. Right. So, first question is, how many equilibriums are possible for this charge in this position? As a positive charge, you know. So, and this is also positive. Its electric field is in this direction. And we all know that a positive charge will experience the force in the direction of electric field only. So, electrostatic force will be acting upwards because electric field is upwards. But mg is acting downwards. Gravitation field is downwards. Okay. Gravitation field is there. Okay, so mg is acting downwards, electrostatic force is acting upwards. So, how many equilibrium positions are possible for this charge? One or two? Two positions, not one position. Why? The reason is, if you look at the graph of the electric field of this disc or this ring, we made it something like this. Right? So, anywhere, if I look at this is electric field and this is x. And if I look at a particular value of QE, the force, or E only, let's say, then single value, you can see that the same value of electric field I am finding at two positions. Okay, this you can say is x1 and this one you can say is x2. So, same value of electric field I am finding at two positions. If it is not maximum. Okay. If maximum value here, that is possible only at one position. QE max. That is only once. But all other values of electric field are found at how many points? Two points. And here in equilibrium, we know that QE is equal to mg. Am I right? That means some value is there. Or E is equal to mg by Q. Correct or not correct? So, two values, rather, E is equal to mg by q, and this mg by q I can find at two positions, right? Remember, there is only one maximum position, but other values I can find at two places. So, here equilibrium we can find at two places. Did you understand that? Right. If equilibrium is found at two positions, then we should be able to decide which is stable and which is unstable also. Are you able to understand? So, we should be able to find out which is stable and which is unstable. Now, suppose this is x1. Right? Now, what I am going to do? I am going to bring it down. So, when you are bringing it down, what is happening? Check. This is x1. When you bring it down, that means you are going towards center. So when you are going towards center, electric field is decreasing or increasing? Decreasing. This is coming down. It's decreasing. Right? So electric field is going down, but mg is same only, no? At this particular position, we are saying QE and mg are equal. Right? When you are bringing it down here QE value is decreasing. That means decreased. And mg is same. What will happen? It will come downwards. It will not go back to this position. Did you understand? We are saying this is equilibrium position where QE equal to mg is there. We are bringing it down. So when you brought it down, what happened? According to this diagram, electric field is decreasing. When electric field is decreasing means electrostatic force QE is also gone down. But mg is same only. So in this position, mg is greater than QE. What will happen? It will come down. Is this equilibrium position was there for the particle? No. This was the equilibrium position. So did it go back? No. So that means this is unstable. This is unstable position. This x1 is unstable. Let's talk about x2 then. Let's understand this. Let's consider now this as x2. Okay. Now this is x2. And at this position, QE and MG are equal. Okay. Now check. This is x2. Now what is happening? As you go away, electric field is decreasing. Okay. So you take it up. You took it up over here. Then what happened? Electric field started decreasing. So if electric field started decreasing, means QE has gone down. Correct or not? QE is less here. QE became less than MG. So what will happen to the particle? Particle will come back. At what position? X2 position. That means it's stable. Let's bring it down and see what is happening. When you are bringing it towards the center, that means from this position, you are going this side towards the center. So see what happens to electric field. Electric field increases. So electric field is increasing. That means QE has increased. Okay, MG remains same. So QE will take it upwards. That means again to equilibrium position. That means X2 is what? Stable equilibrium. Are you able to understand? This is how we need to understand the ring. Okay, at the moment I am finishing it here only, right? In the next class we will see further.